Welcome to this video course of state space control methods. This course is part of the teaching unit Advanced Control 1. This video course covers the theoretical aspects, but it will also cover some exercises which are solved directly. The associated exam will cover both the theory and the exercises. Associated to this video course is a state space control lab. This control lab will apply the theory to a practical example. It goes without saying that you should review the course and the relevant theoretical background before attending the control labs. When attending the control lab, you should bring your own laptop with a working MATLAB installation. All the necessary toolboxes are covered by the MATLAB Simulink student suit. In your state space control lab report, you should put to the front that you have understood the theoretical aspects and you should bring in some elements of originality. The first control lab will cover the implementation of the models, so a nonlinear model and a linearized model, and this will be done in the MATLAB Simulink environment. The second control lab will be dedicated to the design and implementation in the same environment, MATLAB Simulink, of a state space controller. The third control lab will cover the state estimation, that is the implementation of full and reduced order observers. The fourth control lab will be dedicated to the discrete time implementation of the state controllers and observers, again in MATLAB Simulink. As you can see, all four control labs are in simulation using MATLAB Simulink. The real-time implementation on the actual system will be done in the teaching activity Advanced Control on Embedded Systems of the teaching unit Advanced Control 2. More details about the state space control lab can be found in the assignment that is available online. Read this assignment thoroughly and pay special attention to the section on plagiarism and the section on penalties for handing in late the control lab report. It is now time to see what is on the menu of this course. I'll start with an introduction and then I'll go to the section 2, which describes the state space description that will be used in this course. We'll make the link with the input-output description that you've seen in previous courses. We'll make the link with the course of linear algebra, because we need to compute the matrix exponential when we want to find the solution of the state equation. We'll talk about stability and the relation between the two descriptions, the input-output description that is related to the transfer function or the matrix transfer function and the state-space description. We'll talk about discrete time state space systems and we'll see how we can use MATLAB. In section 3, we'll talk about controllability and observability. Loosely speaking, if we want to impose a given closed loop dynamic behavior, the system must be controllable. And in order to see what is going on inside the system under observation, that is, if we want to observe the state, the system must be observable. In section 4, we'll talk about state feedback control. The control law, we will see, is composed of a feed-forward gain acting on the reference or set point and a feedback gain acting on the states. The dynamic response in closed loop is shaped by pole placement. This means that the feedback gain is obtained by choosing appropriate locations for the closed loop poles. We will also investigate optimal state feedback, and in this case, the state feedback gain results from optimization. Then we will see how we can impose integral action and how the control law can be implemented in discrete time. Section 5 covers state observation. When designing a state space controller, we make the assumption that all states are available for measurement. If this is not the case, we need an observer, a state observer. If all states are observed, this is another word for estimated, we speak of a full order observer. If only the states that are not available for measurement are estimated, we speak of a reduced order observer. As for state feedback, we consider state estimation based on pole placement and optimal design. Again, we are interested in implementing the observer in discrete time, as will be the case on the real-time processor. Section 6 will not be covered in this video course. It implements the theory on a DC motor. All theoretical concepts are covered on this practical example in full detail. You should use this section as a guideline when working on the state space control lab assignment. The exam will cover the slides, everything that has been said during the course and or the video course, all the exercises and everything that has been done during the control lab assignment. If you see typos in the slides or you think that things can be improved either in the course, in the slides, during the exercises or in the control lab, well, feel free to contact me. The goal is to improve on this course. MATLAB Simulink plays a very important role in this course, and you should see it as a means of testing a control law using a mathematical model of the system. In other courses, I try to also work with Python in the Anaconda environment, but in this course it's a bit more difficult because I have not found a freeware equivalent of Simulink. Here's a list of references that I've used when preparing this course. You should normally not have to consult these references, but I have to give them out of intellectual honesty. Here is some historical perspective. Classical control, and we mean PID control by that, was first developed in the early 1910s, and by the mid-1950s, PID controllers were widely used for industrial use. In the 1960s, there was this new approach, a state-space approach based on differential matrix equations, and these differential matrix equations replaced the notion of transfer function, and it has become the basis of much of modern control theory. This new way of doing things has given rise to notable success, and one of the highly visible examples is the Apollo project. Well, many control engineers are schooled only in the earlier classical methods using PID control, because the necessary mathematical background is more involved. But in my opinion, both techniques, so classical control, PID control, and state space control, are both useful and complement each other. I will now present a few applications of the course at a camp during the control labs, and at the end there will also be a real life application. The first example is an inverted pendulum that was constructed from an old HP printer. Here the card position and the sway angle are measured. The other two states, the card speed and the sway angle speed, are estimated using a reduced order observer. Two Arduinos are used. The first one is used to implement the observer, and the second one, the state feedback. There is of course a serial communication between the two Arduinos. The programming was done using MATLAB Simulink. The second application is a two-wheeled robot constructed from scratch. A state space speed controller is implemented. Here the sway angle and the sway angle speed are available for measurement using an inertial measurement unit. The robot speed is estimated using a reduced order observer. Again, two Arduinos are used and the programming is done using MATLAB simulink. The third application is on a commercial system, the Amira PS600 inverted pendulum system. Here the state space position controller is combined with a swing up mechanism. When the pendulum is vertical, the state space position controller is activated. The fourth application is with the Edumip two-wheeled robot. More information about this Edumip kit and the Edumip mobile robot can be found on this site. This robot comes in the form of a kit. The wheel position and the sway angle and sway angle speed are available for measurement using an encoder and inertial measurement unit. The wheel speed is estimated through a reduced order observer. The advantage of the Edumip robot is that the controllers, discrete controllers, have to be coded directly in C. In previous applications, the discrete controller were compiled and downloaded using MATLAB simulink, so you didn't have this coding aspect. The fifth application comes from the teaching activity Advanced Control on Embedded Systems in the teaching unit Advanced Control 2. The idea there is to implement the state space controller in real time and to make sure that the robot performs an additional task. In this case, it is line following a black line. As you can see, this is work performed by Julien van Rentergem and Dylan Vervoort. They used infrared sensors to perform the task, and the originality here is the support, the sensor support that stays close to the ground even when the robot is tilting.
Pour conclure ce projet et cette présentation, nous avons ici une vidéo qui montre le robot qui suit une ligne. Et donc ici on va le placer sur la ligne avec l'interface PuTTY qui est juste en dessous pour visualiser les consignes et les valeurs que renvoient les capteurs pour bien montrer la partie software. Donc on peut voir ici que, vu qu'il est dans un tournant, le capteur de droite est à 1. Ici, il est dans une ligne droite, donc c'est 1, 0, 1. On peut voir ici qu'il essaie toujours de s'aligner sur la ligne, c'est tout ce qu'on voulait, et là il arrive à la fin du chemin et donc il va s'arrêter.
The following application is a real-life application of state-space control on a grab crane. Here, anti-sway control with positioning on a grab crane is implemented, and you will see that when the system stops, there is no swaying of the grabber.